Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today's lesson is about sentence structure. Previously we did the sentence types and today we would do the sentence structure. So firstly we would see what is a sentence. We already had discussed it, but we would see that again. A sentence could be defined as a group of words that contains a subject and a predicate, and a sentence is something that expresses a complete thought. And remember that sentence is the largest group of words which conveys a complete thought. We would move ahead and we would see the example of a sentence, and we would also divide the sentence into subject and predicate. So in the first example you may see the baby is smiling. Here the baby is a subject and is smiling is a predicate. You must know that subject is something, like a subject could be a person or thing about whom or which something is said. So what is a subject? Person or thing about whom or about which something is said. That is called a subject. Now what is predicate? What is said about the subject, that is the predicate. So here you see the baby is a subject and is smiling is the predicate, because that gives us information about the subject, which is the baby. And here in this example, my pet is a subject, is a cat. That's the information about my pet, that is a predicate. In this example, mango is a subject and is the national fruit of Pakistan is predicate. Here I born. I is the subject and born is the predicate. So in the here we would see that sentences are classified in two ways, according to use and according to form. Previously we did the classification of sentences according to use, that was called the sentence types, and today we would do the classification of sentences according to form. So according to form, we would see that the sentence is divided into three types: simple sentence, compound sentence and complex sentence. What we would gain by going through this lecture or through this lesson, that would help the students to know about different types of sentences according to structure, and that would help them to construct different forms of sentences. Like they would be able to identify the kinds of sentences and they would also be able to construct different kinds of sentences as well. Before moving to see the kinds of sentences according to structure, firstly I want you to try to understand or get to know about the clauses and the kinds of clauses. You know that clause is something that conveys a complete thought, a complete idea, and that is kind of a sentence. A clause could be a sentence, but don't confuse that a sentence could also be a clause. No, a clause could be a sentence because, like sentence, it contains both the subject and the predicate, as well as that conveys a complete thought, a complete idea. Clause jo hota hai, wo ek complete idea deta hai. Wo ab do tarah ke clauses hote hain, main clause or subordinate clause. So main clause hota hai, that is also called the independent clause, and like the name suggests, tumhe pata chal raha hai, jab independent clause kehte hain to iska matlab hai ki ye independent hota hai, that it could stand in itself, it does not need any other clause for the completion of its meaning. Iska meaning jab aap simple ek main clause ya independent clause likhte ho ya dekhte ho to uska meaning clear hota hai. Uska meaning clear karne ke liye aapko further information ki zarurat nahi hoti. Agar further information aa jati hai to well and good, agar nahi aati to bhi meaning aapke paas clear hota hai. Like you may see this example, you may come to see me and I could not come yesterday. So these are the examples of independent clauses, and they convey a complete thought and complete idea, though some other information is not there with them. In the next example, the next type, that is a subordinate clause, which is also called the dependent clause. And as the name suggests, dependent, that is dependent for one some other kind of a clause for the completion of its meaning. That does not convey a complete thought or complete idea in itself. Rather, it needs some other clause for conveying the complete thought or for the completion of its meaning. That needs some other clause. Like, it depends on the main clause for its complete meaning. You may come to see me whenever you like. So here you would see that this would be the example of the main clause and the subordinate clause. And I could not come yesterday because of rain. I could not come yesterday. That is the example of independent clause. And because of rain, that would be the example of dependent clause, which needs the main clause or the independent clause for the completion of its meaning. Now we would see move towards the types of sentences. And the first is, there is the simple sentence. What is a simple sentence? A simple sentence is one independent clause. Like we looked at the previous, if we look at the previous example, you may come to see me, I could not come yesterday. These are the examples of simple sentence. Because a simple sentence is something that conveys a single idea, a single thought. So we went to Islamabad yesterday. One example of simple sentence, I live in Jhelum, another example. We are Muslims, another example. I love my country, another example of simple sentence. And the second is compound sentence. A compound sentence contains two independent clauses that are joined together. Compound, naam se bhi tumhe lag raha hai ki ek aisa type of sentence hota hai ki jisme do independent clauses ko jab aap join karte ho to wo ek compound sentence banata hai. Ab isme do independent clauses agar hum piche jaye to tumhe pata hai ki independent clause kaun sa hota hai, which can stand alone, jo apna complete meaning convey karta hai. Lekin jab hum do tak independent clauses ko ikattha likh dete hain join karke, तो वो बना देते हैं कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. अब उनको हम कैसे जॉइन करते हैं, इसके लिए हम आगे चल के देखेंगे कि हाउ कुड वी जॉइन देम बाय मेकिंग यूज ऑफ द कंजंक्शंस, बाय मेकिंग यूज ऑफ द ट्रांजिशंस एज वेल एज बाय मेकिंग यूज ऑफ द सेमीकॉलंस. वी वुड सी दैट इन द फर्दर स्लाइड्स, बट हियर यू हैव अ लुक एट दिस एग्जांपल. शी वर्क्स इन द सिटी बट शी लिव्स इन द सबर्ब्स. दैट्स एग्जांपल ऑफ वन कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. यहाँ पे आप देखो कि ये एक क्लॉज है, शी वर्क्स इन द सिटी, वन इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज है. वी डोंट नीड सम अदर इन्फॉर्मेशन, शी वर्क्स इन द सिटी, ओके वेल एंड गुड. लेकिन साथ में अगर फर्दर इंफॉर्मेशन आ जाती है एक दूसरे इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज की शक्ल में, तो दैट वुड मेक अ कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. बट शी लिव्स इन द सबर्ब्स. और इन दोनों इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस को हमने ज्वाइन किया है बट के साथ. एंड व्हाट इज बट? दैट इज अ कंजंक्शन, दैट इज अ कोऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन विच जॉइंस टू इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस. एंड दीज टू इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस जॉइंड विद द कंजंक्शन इज कॉल्ड अ कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. A compound sentence has more than one part that can stand alone. Exactly. इसका मतलब है कि इसके more than one independent clauses से मिलके बना होता है compound sentence. And now how could we make a compound sentence? We could make that by joining two logically related independent clauses. You may say that we may make a compound sentence by joining two independent clauses. और कैसे हम उनको ज्वाइन करेंगे? बाय यूजिंग अ सेमीकॉलन, बाय यूजिंग अ कोऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन एज वेल एज बाय यूजिंग अ ट्रांजिशन. वी वुड मूव अहेड एंड वी विल सी द एग्जांपल ऑफ फर्स्ट द कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. हियर द कंपाउंड सेंटेंस इज मेड बाय जो इज बीइंग हियर द टू इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस आर बीइंग जॉइंड बाय यूजिंग अ सेमीकॉलन. सो इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज, सेमीकॉलन, इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज. जैसे मैथ्स में फार्मूला होता है, ये फार्मूला है जी इसका. उसमें आप देखो पहला इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज, आई लव लिविंग इन द सिटी, सेमीकॉलन. दूसरा इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज, देर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स टू डू, आई लव इन लिविंग इन द सिटी, देर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स टू डू. और इसको अगर आप कह देते हो आई लव लिविंग इन द सिटी एज देर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स टू डू, तो ये भी एग्जांपल होगी कंपाउंड सेंटेंस की. लेकिन वहां पे आपने दो इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस को ज्वाइन किया है एक कोऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन के साथ. इन द अदर एग्जांपल, सम पीपल लाइक बास्केटबॉल, दैट इज वन इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज, सेमी कॉलन. अदर्स प्रिफर बेसबॉल, एन अदर इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज, एंड दे बोथ मेक अप अ कंपाउंड सेंटेंस. We could also make a compound sentence by using a coordinating conjunction. We could join two independent clauses by using a coordinating conjunction. And here this is the formula: independent clause, comma, coordinating conjunction, and another independent clause. We could see he couldn't watch the show, so he decided to tape it. He couldn't watch the show, one independent clause, coordinating conjunction yahan pe hamara hai ji so, and he decided to tape it, that is another independent clause. In the second example, the necklace was beautiful but it was expensive, one independent clause, coordinating conjunction, another independent clause. So here the thing that comes to our mind is, what are the coordinating conjunctions? How could we see that how many are the coordinating conjunctions are there and what are those? So इसमें एक interesting चीज जो है वो ये है कि an easy way to remember the coordinating conjunctions is कि हम इसको अगर हम term use करते हैं fan boys, so that would actually help us to remember that how many coordinating conjunctions are there and what are those. Like these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For F for four, A and nor, B but, O or, Y yet, yes so. So these coordinating conjunctions are used to, these are used before the independent clauses. Whenever in a clause start with any one of these conjunction, it means that is going to be an independent clause and not the dependent clause. So remember, whenever any clause starts with any one of these conjunctions, these are called coordinating conjunctions, any one of these coordinating conjunctions, that would mean that this is an independent clause. And we could also make a compound sentence by using a transition, and here there is the formula: independent clause, semicolon, transition, comma, and then independent clause. Example: I love Karachi, however I hate the traffic. This is a transition and this is one independent clause and this is another. The roads were too busy, independent clause, nevertheless transition, I made my way, another independent clause. So these are the examples, these all are the examples of compound sentences. Another example of a compound sentence that is being made by using a transition: my parents caught a severe cold, consequently they had to cancel their vacation. So next, moving ahead, that's the third type, which is the complex sentence. Now a complex sentence has at least two parts, one that can stand alone and another one that cannot. So yahan se tumhe pata chal jayega ki one that can stand alone ka matlab hai ki ye refer kar raha hai independent clause ko, and another one that cannot stand alone, ye refer kar raha hai dependent clause ko. Matlab ki complex sentence jo hai wo independent aur dependent clauses ko join karke banta hai. Jab bhi aap independent aur dependent clauses ko ikattha join karke likhenge to wo example hogi complex sentence ki. So the part that cannot stand alone is linked to the rest of the sentence by a subordinating conjunction. Pehle humne padhe the coordinating conjunction. Wo kya the? Ki coordinating conjunction hamesha use hota hai independent clause se pehle. Lekin subordinating conjunction jo hai wo use hota hai dependent clause se pehle. Jab bhi subordinating conjunction aa jayega to iska matlab hoga uske baad jo bhi clause aayega definitely wo clause dependent clause hoga. So a complex sentence contains at least one independent clause and one dependent clause. Clear? For example, she will go to school in the city until she finds a job. So she will go to the school in the city, independent clause hai. Until subordinating conjunction hai. She finds a job, ek dependent clause hai. And this dependent clause depends upon the independent clause for the completion of its meaning. Since my friends and I wanted to have fun, we went with the university trip yesterday. So here, we went with the university trip yesterday. Example hai ji, independent clause ki. And since my friends and I wanted to have fun, so that's example of dependent clause. Since subordinating conjunction hai aur jab bhi ye kisi clause se pehle lag jayega to iska matlab hoga ki the jo aage clause aa raha hai wo dependent clause hoga, which would depend upon the main clause for the completion of its meaning. So since my friends I wanted to have fun, incomplete information. You wanted something else for the completion of the meaning and the idea, and the next where comes the main clause, which would complete the meaning conveyed in the first dependent clause. Dependent clause start with the example and subordinating conjunction ke, that, which, who, whom, whose, before, since, when, where, why. So, jab bhi koi bhi clause in words ke saath start hota hai, subordinating conjunctions ke saath, to wo hamesha dependent clause hota hai. The sun never shines on days when I can enjoy it. So, this is independent clause. When, subordinating conjunction, I can enjoy it. Dependent clause. We ate cookies that were made from rice. So we ate cookies. Independent clause, that conjunction, that were made from rice, that is the dependent clause. Okay, have a recap of the three forms of three types of sentences according to structure. My friend invited me to the party. The example of a simple sentence where only a single idea is being conveyed. Next, my friend invited me to the party, but I do not want to go. Here, two ideas are being conveyed by combining two independent clauses. My friend invited me to the party, one independent clause, but coordinating conjunction, I do not want to go, another independent clause. Aur ye dono milke banayenge compound sentence. Next, although my friend invited me to the party, but I do not want to go. So here, although say, although be subordinating conjunction, hai, although my friend invited me to the party. So this is the dependent clause, but coordinating conjunction, hai, I do not want to go. Ye hai ji, independent clause. Usse pehle coordinating conjunction aa gaya, to aapko already idea ho gaya. You are going to have a look at the independent clauses. Aur ye dono milke independent or dependent clause milke compact sentence banayenge. Achha, isme independent clause pehle bhi ho sakta hai aur baad mein bhi aa sakta hai. These are some of the sentences which you need to identify, that what kinds of sentences these are according to the structure, and these are for your practice. And here I would end my lesson today. And if you would be having any queries, you may ask me on Tuesday. Thank you so much.